Well, greetings, Pastor Eric from Zion Lutheran Church in rainy, snowy, central Oregon, beautiful town of Redmond. Good to be with you on day 20. Our time with Colossians had come to an end. 4 weeks of going through these four chapters of Paul's, it's really a love letter to the people that he just loves and cares for in Colossae. I talked yesterday a little bit about, as we end now at the end of January, I'll be sending you a prayer journal in the mail before Ash Wednesday. We have 40 days of prayer. In the prayer journal, we'll have Sundays and Wednesday church. On Monday and Friday, I will send you a kind of an update on the prayer stuff, kind of walking through that journal. So look for that in the mail. If you need two of them, email me that you need two, one for you and your spouse or kids or whatever that might be. We can send out as many as you'd like. Today we're on chapter 4, verses 10 through 18. And I call this guy Archie. I don't know what his name is, Aristocrus. Okay, I don't think that's the best name that his mother gave him. But Archie, my fellow prisoner, greets you, my fellow prisoner, as does Mark, the cousin of Barnabas, concerning whom you have received instructions. If he comes to you, welcome him. And Jesus, who is also called Justice, greets you. These are the only ones of the circumcision among my co-workers for the kingdom of God, those who are people, Jewish Christians, and they have been a comfort to me. Verse 12, Epaphras, okay? We've heard about him the whole time. Who is one of you, from Colossae, a servant of Christ Jesus, greets you. He is always wrestling in his prayers on your behalf. Wrestling in his prayers on your behalf. So that you may stand mature, like we've talked about, mature Christians, and fully assured in everything that God wills. For I testify for him that he has worked hard for you and for those in Laodicea and Hierapolis. Remember, we talked about the tri-cities of Colossae, Hierapolis, and Laodicea. So those are the cities that Epaphras had started house churches in. Luke, the beloved physician, Luke, the gospel writer, if you saw the reference to that, Luke, servant of the gospel, I forgot what that was I mentioned in the email yesterday. Try to watch that. Luke is with Paul in prison. It's an hour and a half or so on Amazon Prime. You'll love that time looking at that on Amazon Prime after we've been through Colossians together. Luke, the beloved physician, and Demas greet you. We'll talk about him in a moment. Give my greetings to the brothers and sisters in Laodicea and to Nympha and the church in her home. She was a church leader of a small gathering in her home. And when this letter has been read among you, have it also read in the church of the Laodiceans, and see that you read also the letter from Laodicea. We don't have that letter. We don't know exactly what that is. And say to Archie, see that you complete the task that you have received in the Lord. Finally, I, Paul, write this greeting with my own hand. Remember my chains. Grace be with you. And with that, Paul ends the letter. You know, when we used to go to movies and they have the credits at the end, this is what this is, except that the movie you want to walk out, here you want to hear about who these people are that Luke mentions at the end of his gospel. You know, Paul was not only a soul winner, not only a passionate missionary, but he was also a friend maker. Paul was friends with so many people. There are more than 100 different Christians, named and unnamed, that Paul talks about in his letter, in the book of Acts, in the epistles. Paul names 26 different friends in Romans 16, last chapter of Romans, alone. So it's customary at Paul's time to close your letter sending greetings to people because, you know, you couldn't text them, you couldn't Facebook them. So when you wrote a letter, he said, oh, greet so-and-so, greet so-and-so. So Paul sent personal greetings to Colossae from six of his associates in the ministry Archie, John Mark, Jesus Justice, all of whom were Jewish Christians, and Epaphras, Luke, and Demas, who were Gentiles. Luke was a Gentile who was commissioned to write the Gospel of Luke. We talked about that when we went in the 24 days through the Gospel of Luke. You know, those people that he mentions, those six people, really can be broken into three groups. First group is the men who stayed with Paul. So Archie, John Mark, and Jesus Justice, and Luke, three Jews and one Gentile, stayed with Paul. All three were characterized with faithfulness at Paul's hour of special need. They were the men who stayed. Archie, Aristarchus, this person, man, was identified as Paul's fellow prisoner and fellow worker. Probably not in prison for the same reason Paul was, but staying there with Paul. He was originally from Macedonia, and he stayed with Paul no matter what the circumstance. Acts has a couple of times where it says that Archie and Paul were in a boat together, traveling together, going to Rome together, shipwrecked together. Paul could not have accomplished everything he did apart from the work of some of his friends, and Archie, Aristarchus, stayed with him through thick and thin. John Mark was another one that he mentions. Paul and Barnabas went on their first missionary journey. They also took John Mark with them as their assistant. So John Mark was with them from the beginning on some of the travels. Somehow John Mark quit going with them. They left him behind at one point. It's not really explained why, but it's just said he left, but he kind of kept in good relations with them. Keep that in mind for a second. John Mark failed, in a sense, in going and starting with them, but then falling away. And yet, even though he fell away, he was welcomed back as someone that Paul loved. He had fallen away, but kind of like the prodigal son, he was always welcomed back. Jesus Justice was a Jewish believer who served with Paul. We really don't know anything about Jesus Justice. The name Jesus is Joshua was a popular name at that time. But we don't know much about him because not much more is said. Luke was the beloved physician. He was the one who authored the Gospel of Luke. Probably the only Gentile writer of any book in the Bible. Think of that. Luke was the only Gentile writer of any book in the New Testament. He was a physician, and in the book of Acts, which Paul wrote, many of the travel stories that Paul wrote about the early church and Paul's travel, the ship dialogues, they're the we ship dialogues, where Luke writes in Acts about Paul's travel, using the words we, presuming that Luke did a lot of traveling with Paul. That's part of the reason he could write the Acts of the Apostles, because he traveled with Paul. The man who prayed is a second group. We talked about those three. The man who prayed, Epaphras, was at the beginning of the study. He was a man who founded the church at Colossae. He had been led to Christ through Paul's work in Ephesus, and he went back home to Colossae, his hometown, and also started home churches in Laodicea and Hierapolis. He was a home missionary, a home church starter. One of the wonderful things about Epaphras was his prayer life. He shared the same room in prison with Paul sometimes, and when Epaphras prayed, Paul knew about him. He was able to see how he prayed. In fact, he's always wrestling in his prayers on your behalf. What a description. What a wonderful description. He prayed constantly. He prayed fervently. He prayed personally. Epaphras was concerned that these Christians in his hometown of Colossae not only know the will of God, but also do it. He wanted them to be involved in doing the will of God, not just kind of intellectually knowing about it. The Gnostics taught that people could reach perfection and maturity through this kind of secret knowledge. Remember, we've talked about that multiple times. But Epaphras and Paul taught that only in Christ can we know those blessings, live in them with our hearts, and act them out with our hands. So these men that Paul named were commended. They were commended in one way or another. Epaphras is the only one who was commended for his prayer life. Epaphras prayed for the believers in those different cities. He was a man of prayer. Now, there's also the man who strayed. Okay, Demas is mentioned here. Demas is mentioned only three times in Paul's letters. And the story of Demas kind of tells a sad story. Paul talks about him a couple times as, two times of the three, as my fellow laborer. But then the third reference is Demas forsook me, having loved this present world. So Demas was with him, but instead of like the guy who kind of came back, Demas was the one who actually didn't come back. John Mark was the one who came back. Demas did not come back. We don't know why John Mark left Paul for a while, but then was welcomed back. We don't know exactly why Demas left Paul, but Demas left, forsook Paul for the love of this present world. So Paul goes into the final greetings. Nympha was a church person who had a meeting in her house. And it's worth noting that Paul just really encourages them in this letter, seeing their life and their ministry as a loving gift from a gracious God. So we end this time of Colossians, these 4 weeks in Colossians, these 20 days. I hope you've enjoyed working our way through it along with Philemon and kind of getting a sense for Paul's passion for the people here at this small town of Colossians, Hierapolis, and Laodicea. And he's encouraging them to stick in the word. Stick in the word. Even though Paul is persecuted, he is going to be killed in the next while after he wrote these letters. And yet, he passionately talks about keeping steady to know Jesus, know and do his will. I think Colossians fits so well with us today because we too need to be kept close to God. We need to attend worship in online if that's all we have right now. We need to be in Bible study. We need to pray for one another. Think about how you in the coming days, weeks, immerse yourself in prayer for our country, for our community, for our church, for your own faith. So continue to read through Colossians, work through the prayer journal that you'll be getting in about 2 weeks, and then look for those online kind of guides during the season of Lent. Great to be with you. Let's close in a word of prayer. Dear God, thanks for this wonderful letter to the Colossians, for all of the wisdom and guidance, insights, encouragement that Paul gives from his prison cell to not only the people of Colossae, but Hierapolis, Laodicea, and to us. Keep us close to you. Keep us searching your word for comfort and guidance that we need so badly at this time. Keep us ever and always close to you. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, I look forward to seeing you again, which is going to come again before you know it. You take care then. Bye-bye.